Elastic Jobs allow you to create and manage jobs that can be periodically executed against one or many databases to run T-SQL or various maintenance tasks. Learn more on this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. I'm Anna Hoffman, and today I'm joined by SQLDB PM Kate Smith. Kate, thanks so much for joining us today.
Happy to be here, Anna.
And today we're going to talk about Elastic Jobs, and this is something I really don't know anything about. So, Kate, can you start by just telling us what are Elastic Jobs?
Sure, absolutely. So, in the world of databases, it's very common for common maintenance tasks to need to be done on a database. So anything that you might schedule or that you might do across a large number of databases, like the same task either over and over again day after day or over and over again across this database and this database and this database, Elastic Jobs allow you to do that in a very streamlined and powerful way. It's write the T-SQL script once and set up the job and you're good to go.
That's awesome. And, you know, you kind of talked about maintenance. You know, when should we use Elastic Jobs?
That's a great question. So database maintenance can look like a lot of things. But some examples that come to mind would be partition maintenance or statistics updates or statistics maintenance or index maintenance or any type of data maintenance that you might do. Or it could even be something like a schema update, adding a column, for example. Now, schema updates are an unusual type of maintenance that you might do just on one time, but that would be executed across a large number of databases, whereas some of these other maintenance tasks, index and stats updates, you would do like every night or every week or every month, something like that.
Cool, awesome. So it seems like there's kind of a wide range of possibilities for when I might use this.
Yeah, if you can define it in T-SQL and define it the right way, we'll talk about that later, but so that it could be run again and again, then you can run it in an Elastic Job.
Awesome, cool. And, you know, I guess kind of the final question is, what database is this supported in?
So this is an Azure SQL database specific offering. It does not work on premise type offerings, but it works in almost all of our Azure SQL offerings. So our standard tier, premium tier, general purpose, basic, Hyperscale supports this, serverless supports this, Elastic Pools support this. Basically, the only exception at this point is Managed Instance, which supports sort of the on-prem analog to this, which is SQL Server Agent.
Cool. And so if I was using SQL Server Agent and I moved to Azure SQL Database, is Elastic Jobs something that I can use to kind of fulfill the same purpose?
Yeah. So if you're running jobs on-prem and using SQL Server Agent to do maintenance, you can take any sort of T-SQL that you have already written for your SQL Server Agent. If you move your database over to Azure, you can take those T-SQL scripts and set them up in Elastic Jobs. To run in Azure. That is the offering, basically. SQL Server Agent, with the exception of Managed Instance, is not supported in Azure, but Elastic Jobs are the way forward for all those other offerings.
Awesome. Great. Well, Kate, thanks so much for coming on today. This is a great intro to Elastic Jobs, and I think we're going to do a few more of these, so maybe people should tune in, and we'll also post some links to the blogs that you've done as well.
Yes, yeah, that's a very powerful, very cool tool that I'm excited to see people using it.
Awesome. Thanks, Kate, and thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like it and subscribe to our channel or comment on what you're doing with Elastic Jobs. Thanks.